Okay, so to my right, making his debut on NewsHour tonight, spokesperson of the NCP, Clyde Cresto. Clyde, thanks very much. To my left is Devendra Fadnavis, who is president of the Maharashtra BJP and MLA, upcoming leader of the BJP. And to his left, of course, is Shailesh Gandhi, former CIC and India's well-known RTI activist. At the bottom left of your screen out there is Satish Manashinde, senior advocate. To his right on the screen there is Kirit Somaya, senior BJP leader, and Abhishek Manu Singhvi, national spokesperson and MP of Rajya Sabha of the Congress Party. Now, generally, before I begin with you asking you some questions, I first want to give the opportunity to the BJP. Devendra Fadnavis, the Congress Party will try to argue legally today, argue technically and argue legally to find a way out. They will say that perception does not really matter in this case. And they will say that there was no compulsion on the Chief Minister to do anything, regardless of what Rahul Gandhi promised. I want you to begin with your counter to Abhishek Manu Singhvi, since I would presume some of his arguments would be of that nature. He can prove me wrong. Devendra Fadnavis, your counter to Abhishek Singhvi first.
See, this new ATR is absolute intellectual dishonesty. It's a quid pro quo between Congress and NCP. You spare me, I'll spare you.
Okay.
If you look at the point number 12 in the ATR, they say that only political patronage is mentioned.
Yeah.
No criminal liability is mentioned in the report. That is why we are not considering a political liability. Now, if you look at the IPC, two big lawyers are here and I am commenting on law.
But go ahead, go straight ahead.
If you look at IPC, even wrongful loss or wrongful gain also amounts to a criminal offence. In the instant case, if you see,
I see a straight disagreement.
Prakash Pethe, road based issue or a file which has to be sent to a cabinet is been signed by the Chief Minister himself without sending it to the Council of the Ministers. All these things attract a criminal liability. Why then are you waiting?
You see, repeatedly on that, I will also add here. Let's get Abhishek Singhvi's response. But I just like to add before that to Abhishek Manu Singhvi that repeatedly, when the Congress Party said, what morality does the BJP talk about? What did the Congress Party say? Congress Party said perception matters. Because of perception, we took action against Kalmadi. Because of perception, we took action against Ashok Chauhan. Because of perception, we took action against A. Raja. Because of perception, we took action against Shashi Tharoor. Because of perception, we made Jagdish Taitla quit the Union Cabinet. Right? Now, all that perception argument today, Abhishek Singhvi, I presume, has gone for a toss 2 weeks before Rahul Gandhi is to be declared the Prime Ministerial candidate. Why did you allow this eyewash? Why, Dr. Singhvi? Politically, it's suicide.
Arnab, let me start by complimenting you to first presume my arguments and get a rebuttal in advance before you ask me. That's really a technique we have to learn from you. Secondly, let me tell you that the devil and God both lie in the details. And ultimately, you have to give
me a couple of minutes. I'm willing to debate every detail with you, Dr. Singhvi.
Let me tell you straight away that it is an extreme proposition and complete misleading to suggest that the Congress is not acting in an exemplary fashion. I'm using the word exemplary.
You want to give yourself a certificate?
Let me be very quick. I know that you have limited time. I don't need to give myself. The facts give us a certificate. Who has appointed this independent commission of inquiry which has given such a strong report? The Congress did.
Who rejected it? You got six people out there.
I'm happy to keep quiet. You will not finish your program unless you give us 2 minutes.
The Maharashtra Chief Minister.
No point.
No, you've given yourself a certificate, Dr. Singhvi.
I insist on taking my 2 minutes to speak gibberish. Please allow me my.
But then after
right
that, you have a lot to answer for tonight. Yes, go ahead. We give you the time.
Yes,
complete
yes,
your
after
comments.
I'm prepared to answer any question.
Yeah.
Any question you ask me. So we appoint the commission. Mr. Chauhan resigns before the slightest action.
He does nobody a favor.
Unlike Babulal Bokheria, who sits in the Modi cabinet, whom you don't ask a question. Unlike
you just asked a series of questions once again today. Anyway,
denied by Mr. Modi.
That's all
unlike
right.
Unlike Mr. Sancheti,
don't shoot
who
off.
Has six or seven or eight flats. Anyway, leave that aside. Thirdly, the Mr. Chavan, who resigns before the slightest thing against him, no finding, is already under prosecution. Number four, there's already an FIR, there's already a prosecution, already a CBI inquiry.
Is there, apart from ED, has the NIT. Governor given sanction of prosecution?
Now, number four, please,
has the governor given sanction of prosecution? Shailesh Gandhi. Shailesh Gandhi. Has the governor given sanction of prosecution?
Has the governor. The government of Maharashtra has taken a position in High Court that CBI has no jurisdiction. It's a position taken by the government of Maharashtra in the High Court. That CBI has no jurisdiction. And now you say that CBI will prosecute. And I would like to tell you one thing, that this report has been placed before the legislature because of High Court's order. Your chief minister was not ready. According to the act, within 6 months, you have to place a report before the legislature. You did not. BJP went to the High Court and High Court directed. And that is why this report came into public domain. Otherwise, it was junked.
My question is very simple. Maharashtra, chief, there is a chief minister. Abhishek Singh, let's listen to this. There is a chief minister who is being protected. When Rahul Gandhi was asked the question, what do you want to do? And he says, I personally don't agree with the decision on Adarsh. He raised expectations, didn't he, Shailesh Gandhi?
Absolutely.
What did you expect after that?
We expected that he would say, we accept this because when I appoint the Commission of Inquiry, the members were selected by the Chief Minister and by this government.
Yeah.
After that, you can't say because it's inconvenient to me.
Or because the ex-chief minister is close to
I heard Dr. Singhvi saying that he found the part about Sancheti very lovely in that report. But there are other things that he doesn't like. So everybody is doing cherry picking in this whole
game. So he wants to pick and choose out here.
That's right.
Yeah. So, you know, you can't pick and choose. The question is, Abhishek Manu Singhvi, why this is an eyewash? I want to question you one-on-one. The Maharashtra chief minister has completely, Dr. Singhvi, he completely, no, Dr. Singhvi, listen.
I'm not willing to answer, Arnab, unless I get my 2 minutes. No, I'm not answering.
Dr. Singhvi, you are not willing to answer.
With you. I am not answering unless you preemptively stop others from interrupting me because you are scared of hearing the truth.
Dr. Singhvi.
I'm not charging them, I'm charging you.
Dr. Singhvi, you can.
Getting the others to preemptively interrupt me without hearing my answer.
Dr. Singhvi.
I'm prepared to face any question from you.
Dr. Singhvi.
If you hear my answer.
You can put any accusation at me. You can put any accusation at me. But I will hear your answer.
I'm only putting an accusation of natural justice denial.
And you do appreciate Dr. Singhvi.
You are denying me natural justice.
Dr. Singhvi, you do appreciate that the fact is that on this issue, your government is in the dock.
You've got a majority of people criticizing the Congress. Not only are you interrupting me, you're getting them to interrupt
me. Dr. Singhvi, I don't have a majority of people criticizing the Congress. Is the Congress party which is in a minority on issues of propriety here?
Hear the defense.
Okay, we give you 1 minute.
Go. It'll be quicker if you allow me to speak.
So you complete your point, but then I'll throw 3 questions at you and you'll have to answer those. Go ahead.
Yes, but after I finish my point.
Go ahead.
The first time we did, I hope it's better this time. The jurisdictional question, surely anybody is entitled to raise in the High Court. It arises from the finding of this commission, which you are relying so heavily upon, Arnab, as far as the panel is concerned here. This commission holds this is Maharashtra land. It is not government of defense land. If it is Maharashtra land, the CBI, on one reckoning of law, has no jurisdiction.
So
that's a point the High Court will decide. Now, what you are saying is a finding of the same commission that this is state government land, which allows that jurisdictional objection to be raised or not to be raised because Mr. Gandhi or others say that it should not be raised.
Okay, now you know.
Fourth point.
Now,
there is a clear finding. 1 minute. There is a clear suggestion in the Commission of Inquiry, which is not final. I'm accepting, by the way, the Commission of Inquiry as final. It is not final. I'm accepting against myself.
Why do you set up an inquiry if you want to reject it?
There is a quid pro quo, Mr. Chavan. But there is absolutely no suggestion of any criminal inference or quid pro quo against the others, namely Mr. Shinde and Mr. Patil, and Mr. Deshmukh is dying now.
Now, don't, you so don't, you know, you know, you know, no, no, I don't, one second.
And Mr. Chawla,
now you made your point.
He's already under prosecution.
No, no, now you made your point. Now you made your point. I want to get it. Kirit Somaiya here.
No, Arnav, just a moment.
Okay.
When Mr. Manu Singhvi says that jurisdiction question can be raised, on one hand, you are raising jurisdiction question, and on other hand, in the ATR, you say that the CBI will look at it because we don't want to file another FIR. So we are relying on CBI to do to prosecute. On one hand, you say CBI has no jurisdiction. On other hand, you say CBI will look into it.
There is a valid confession. There is a valid confession by this gentleman that he's not a lawyer. He doesn't know the law.
The gentleman is 100% correct, and he is a lawyer.
Pending.
The gentleman who said that, Dr. Devendra Fadnavis, is not just 100% correct. He's also a lawyer. Because, and Kirit Somaiya wants to come in to challenge you as well.
Correct.
Because,
your subject.
Because, one second. Because,
Abhishek,
is already an ongoing FIR.
Kirit Somaiya to Abhishek Singhvi. Kirit Somaiya.
Connivance and convenience. Is it not connivance and convenience? First, it is the issue of connivance. And now for convenience, on one side, Abhishek says that who has appointed commission? Who appointed CBI investigation? This is the Congress government appointed CBI and initiated investigation. When Prithviraj Chauhan was at PMO, he asked CBI to take over. When he come to CMO, he immediately stopped CBI. On one side, he asked, let CBI continue the investigation. When CBI arrested 7 bureaucrats,
completely wrong.
Abhishek Singhvi, Rahul Gandhi, Prithviraj Chauhan did not stop them. When they started arresting Ashok Chauhan, the politician, immediately the government goes to High Court and challenge CBI's jurisdiction. So this is the connivance, convenience and commission.
No, you
whenever
see,
it should, they
Dr. Singhvi, you see, this is a very simple case. It's not as complicated as you are trying to make it out to be. One day, the government says the CBI has no right to look at this whole matter. Now, allegations of Benami flats, quid pro quo, Ashok Chauhan in trouble. So the same state government gets up and says, we can't decide. It's the CBI's job to decide. But hello.
No.
You just a few days back, you said that CBI has no powers. Today, because you are scared. A, because you are scared. B, because the CBI is under your control. C, because the CBI is a caged parrot.
Correct you.
B, because you want to buy time.
Respectfully,
D, because Ashok Chauhan is close to Rahul Gandhi. You don't want to take action against Ashok Chauhan. You are looking for silly excuses, Abhishek Singhvi. You are looking for silly excuses not to act against Ashok Chauhan.
1 minute to correct you.
No, there is no correction here.
There is a fundamental point here.
I can challenge you on
facts. The allegation made when this whole dispute started, the allegation made was that this is defense land.